Way I'm Livin' is a great record. I think, you know, it's like...
Thank you.
When you first came out, I was in doing country radio, and it was leaps and bounds above what was going on back then as far as I was concerned. It was like real gut bucket country, you know, and it needed to happen during that time period. And it was refreshing, even though it was had that sort of Floyd Kramer piano going on in it with the, you know, the A-team session players of the day back in the 60s and 70s, what that felt like. But it seems like you come all the way back around, and this record, your latest one, is back in that mode again.
We certainly, I've done so many different kinds of things over the course of my career, from the real hardcore traditional mm-hmm. country stuff, which is what I love most, and it's just a part of me. And then, you know, and then I had a huge pop crossover hit, mm-hmm. you know, which is so ironic, I don't even know where to begin, but for somebody that sounds like me, you know, to have that kind of song. But I think it comes down to believability. I mean, people listen to you and they either want to hear what you have to say or not, you know? And so it's like the huge success of Oh Brother. Who would have ever thought
right.
commercial success would come to you know, Ralph Stanley singing Oh Death, you mm-hmm. know? So I think people understand what's real and they want it. And I didn't know any better, you know, when I made my first record. I cut Never Again. I had Ricky Skaggs and Sharon White come mm-hmm. in and sing harmony. I didn't know any better.
It's a great way to start.
From the time I was a little girl, I wanted to go to Nashville and make country records. But by the time I got here, they quit doing that,
right.
you know. And so,
yeah.
But still, that was all I knew.
Yeah. Something kind of out of your comfort zone, like with like Johnny Cash did, not that it was necessarily out of his comfort zone, but like he did with Rick Rubin.
Right, yeah,
you know, and maybe let someone take you to a place that you never thought you'd go.
I relish the idea of doing something like that, of course.
So I thought that would be a good project for you mm-hmm. to do. Mm-hmm. Enzo,
yes, sir.
Make a note.
Get Rick Rubin on the phone, would you?
I'm on the line right now.
All right.
After Whataburger, call Rick Rubin.
Tell him we got Whataburger for him if he'll produce Lee Ann. All right?
Good deal.
So
yeah, I love that. And that's but I'm married to one of the greatest producers of all time, you know, and he does that kind of stuff. He's mm-hmm. always pushing people to get a little bit out of their comfort zone.
Right.
And so Music is music, and I love, like, I just did, taped a TV show a few months ago with John Legend, and that's totally out of my, I mean, he's a pop,
right?
All piano-driven mm-hmm. music, you know, and when CMT approached him about doing it and they played him my new record, he was like, I'm all about this guitar-driven stuff, you know? I mean, he wanted to do that same kind of thing. And so, yeah, I think musicians love to do that sort of stuff.
Singing, oh, mama, the way that I'm living, lying and sinning, and I just can't change. Oh, mama, the way that I'm living, if I ever get to heaven, it's a doggone shame.
Start to pray.
Has your audience changed that for you? I'm sure you've got the diehard fans that will come out to see you no matter what, but you've kind of gotten associated with the Americana buzz. Have you seen your fan base change after that?
A little bit.
Yeah.
You know, I've always worked a little bit in that world. I'll go out and sing with Patty Griffin. You know, she's had me out on stage with her and Lucinda, and of course Buddy Miller I've worked with a lot. Jim Lauderdale I've worked with a lot and sung on their records. They sing on mine, and we do live things together. And so I've always worked a little bit in that world. The rooms that I'm playing this year are really listening rooms, and you see a lot more of those kinds of fans or audience members now. I do.
Do you do full band or a smaller band or than you used to?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I love because it really opens up. And I want to just, it's fun to sing with just bass. I mean, it's fun to sing with just acoustic guitar too. But when you get down to just bass, it really gives you a lot of room to sing, you know, and I love that.